A good party always includes a great cocktail, and that's why Matt Landis, founder of the Cocktail Academy, is here to tell us about Oscar cocktails inspired by some of the Best Picture nominations. Matt, welcome.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here.
Nice to have you.
Feels like you were just here for last year's Oscars.
Last year was the highlight. Being here was the highlight of Oscar season.
Oh,
and the fact that it's, let alone award season, I can't believe it. Just really happy to be back here with you.
Well, you always bring the gold, the beautiful, the display. Much like fashion, cocktails have trends, and you guys specialize in that.
Correct.
So what are we looking at here?
So this year we had some really great Oscar noms for Best Picture. And like always, our clients are asking us for Oscar week parties to showcase their film.
Okay.
If it's their studio, if it's their actor, or whatever it is. And so this year we picked four. So what we're looking at is Cliff Booth's Bloody Mary from Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
Why a Bloody Mary?
Well, it's a Bloody Mary because in the beginning of the movie, he's sitting at the bar at Max, what's the name of the famous
bar? Musso and Frank.
Musso and
Frank. Sorry, I'm not Max.
Thank you.
We look similar. You're the New York version of me. And cooler.
Musso and Frank
and
is a staple in LA, it's a staple in Hollywood, and he orders a margarita.
And he orders a Bloody Mary because it is a staple. And also in that movie, everybody's hungover all the time.
Love it.
Okay.
And they need hair on the a little hair on the dog. And so this is classic, this is fun. I like a spicy Bloody Mary, so there's paprika, there's horseradish, delicious, you have to try it.
But you're not trying to reinvent the wheel with this one.
No.
Just a classic celery.
I'm trying
celery.
To perfect it. Yeah, there's definitely like a little yummy salt rim here with paprika, salt, pepper,
here,
a little
sugar.
I'll
grab it. I can show the camera over here.
And you should drink it. Oh, I do want to say, I apologize.
What's
up? Word on the street is that KTLA cannot handle their liquor.
That's what it is!
And I mean, I've seen it, so I know as well.
So
and
these
so
are
all
mocktails.
Of these are mocktails. This
Love
is
it.
You can do this at
this
home.
This is just juice.
This is just juice.
Great.
But it's delicious juice. Can you please try it?
I will.
I was hoping you would pull a fast one on us and give us the real ones, but
that
these are actually mocktails.
I learned after it was a train wreck.
Ooh. Turns out V8 is great.
But what is in there?
V8.
And what would I add to
it? Okay, so organic tomato juice,
okay.
Salt, pepper. Celery salt, paprika, Worcestershire.
Salt.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
More like Bestershire. Hey, come on.
That's
thank you. Thank you for acknowledging me. That is fantastic.
Tabasco.
Even as a cold soup in a glass, it is very, very good. It does have that vibe, but you can imagine, you know, throw your favorite liquor in there. That would be very tasty.
Oh, I put some delicious vodka in there.
It's so
good. Oh, actually, I put mezcal in there too. But.
Ooh.
For the for the award season cocktail for Cliff Booth Bloody Mary, we recommend.
Here, just drink it. Just have some.
I just need.
But there's
breakfast.
So many other cocktails.
Yeah.
Everybody focus.
I want to eat that watermelon so badly.
That is your watermelon.
Okay.
Okay. So you're looking at the Parasite cocktail. Okay. I know you're like, how is this the Parasite cocktail? That movie is so weird and so amazing, and this is so simple and Americana. Well, exactly, because the son in Parasite loves. Kind of like the Americana cowboy and Indian. So this cocktail is called the Giddy Up.
Okay.
It takes place kind of like this cocktail would have been made at that barbecue in the last scene. So what we did to make it non-alcoholic is fresh watermelon juice, lime, little splash of agave, and then some cracked black pepper just to kind of wake you up just like when everyone starts. Spoiler alert, killing each other at the end.
Stop!
Oh,
wow.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I haven't seen it.
What the heck? What would you add to it to make it not a
I would add tequila.
Cocktail, a mocktail. You'd add tequila.
Make
not
it a
mezcal,
real margarita.
Tequila.
I would add mezcal, but the general Los Angeles population and the Oscar trend is to drink as much tequila as possible. When we're working the Oscar events, whether it's the pre-parties for the agencies or the governor's ball or
the
private parties, it's tequila, 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 tequila.
So is that the most requested? That's what you're saying is the most requested?
Okay.
Because it's both like get wild and also feels like kind of fancy.
So, and they kind of think it's like medicinal or healthy because from the agave plant we're like a potato is carb and that's like anti. So no vodka, no corn.
The tequila grows from the earth.
Grows from the earth. And then mezcal they get even crazier because then it's in an earth oven. It's like born of the soil.
Don't you love LA? Don't you love us?
Oh, you ready for some ASMR?
Wow. Ooh.
I'm not into that, but if I was, I really would have loved that.
I'm disgusted.
Yeah. I'm very like nails on the chalkboard about that.
Actually.
How is that?
Actually, should we stop?
Exquisite.
Isn't it delicious?
Oh my gosh.
So, guys,
I'm just going to keep
If you are sober, this is Los Angeles, 12-step capital of the world. This is a fabulous cocktail. or if you just don't feel like drinking alcohol, mocktails are so much fun and they're festive and a great way to make a party fun.
Well, this is so good also without anything else in it that it's just fun to drink, even if you just were like, I'm just making a fun little fancy drink.
And it could only get better if you do drink. If you do add
tequila.
Let's move on to this baby's breath.
So what you're looking here, the baby's breath is actually edible. So you wouldn't think so, but it is. And we try at Cocktail Academy not to put anything in a drink that actually isn't edible. So this cocktail is for little women. And this, the name of this cocktail is Love is a Great Beautifier. Hold on, let me tell you what it is before
okay,
it shocks
smelling,
you.
I'm smelling.
Now, it is, in this case, think of the best Arnold Palmer, most feminine delicious Arnold Palmer. So it is a tea infusion of chamomile and rose.
That smells so good. Okay? It smells like a fancy lady.
A little bit
lady.
Of honey, a little bit of, it is very
you know what
fancy.
I mean? Like
I mean,
a
the
fancy
ladies
old
aren't
lady.
That fancy there.
No, no, but this.
And they're young and dynamic, but yeah, we're gonna say
this woman wears St. John. That is the drink.
She does, and she's
do
and she sprays Boucheron.
Oh, of course.
She's wearing Boucheron. Now, that cocktail
is
amazing with vodka as well.
Okay.
Okay.
She drives a really expensive Volvo.
Yes.
Like the top of the line. Can I try?
Correct. Yeah, or like a 90s Jag.
That's, you know, that's more right.
Okay, so yeah. A Thunderbird, perhaps, if she's real fancy in Palm Springs.
Yeah, if her blue hair is flying.
Oh, blue hair.
That's very good.
Oh,
you think she drives you're on a different level than us. I love your appreciation
of life,
though.
So does it taste as good as it smells?
Yes, it tastes so good.
You want to try
it? I do. Okay, and then I see this nice, awesome, I feel like ice is also very, very trendy, and it also signifies the class of the drink.
Correct.
And I see this big old ice block over here.
Yes.
Clear as day.
Did you say you referenced the Titanic when we were talking about it?
Well, no, that was a drink we were making prior. It had a lot of ice particles on top of the drink, and I said we got to use that good strainer so we don't have like an iceberg water situation like the Titanic.
You were telling us, and I learned this today, this is a good strainer because it has real tight curls.
Yes, really tight curls. So there's lots of things that go into great cocktails. I'll just tell you a few, okay? Ice is very important. Ice is the bartender's fire, right? That for like a chef has fire, bartender is ice. Let me clarify.
Okay.
So we're cooking, we're diluting, we're chilling. Also, glassware is a really great way to tell the cocktail story. We chose these. You could try different ones at home. Garnish is a great way to elevate. And then fresh ingredients, obviously very important. Mm-hmm. We love bar tools presentation. As we say at Cocktail Academy, people drink with their eyes first. Just like when you go to a restaurant, you care about the plating.
Absolutely.
We care about the glassing. I don't know if that's...
Sure. And like this one, which is so fun.
This is going to be the Joker, and the cocktail is called The Joke's on You, and the joke is really on you, because I'm going to have both of you make this cocktail. And there is beet in it.
Joke's on you.
All right, there is beet in it.
Okay.
So you're going to get it all over your gorgeous dress.
It would kind of blend in.
Anyway, so I have a Cocktail Academy apron
for you.
Oh, look at us getting all fancy.
Everyone in the studio audience also has them under their chair.
And you, you all get an apron. You're hired.
Okay.
Okay, I'm sorry. Thank you.
Look, a little denim, very fancy.
All right, well, we'll see if you're going to get hired at the end of this.
Yeah, you're way too tall. You need to sit down.
Oh, yeah, true. My head is...
I'm going to fix my microphone here.
I'm gonna squat. I'm gonna grab the bar tools.
Okay, grab it. And these are your personal
These are my personal bar tools. Okay. I love gold bar tools because it makes me feel festive and like fancy. So what we're gonna do here is you're going to shake.
Okay.
And you're going to pour in the ingredients into a small tin.
Dig it.
Okay?
Okay.
So what we're gonna start with is we're gonna do equal parts for the non-alcoholic. Actually, no, we're not. We're gonna do 2 ounces of this. 2 ounces of the fresh pressed beet juice. Just, okay, just go up to there. That's a graduated jigger, super confusing.
No, it's very fancy.
So is it 1, 2, 3, 4?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Perfect, right there.
Is that good?
In. That's fabulous.
And you want two parts of that, or is that
enough? Great. And then you're gonna put
1 ounce
halfway
of this.
I
guess this is what I still need, huh? Look at this.
Beet juice,
That is fresh ginger syrup.
Ginger syrup,
watch out, you're spilling everywhere.
Classic.
Such a mess. He's not hired yet.
All right. Sorry.
This is fresh lemon.
Okay.
Okay, perfect, go halfway. Equal parts. So whenever you're making a cocktail, a great rule is equal parts lemon to citrus. I mean, citrus to sugar.
Oops. Oh, interesting.
All right, great. So now we're gonna add, you have your ice in here already.
I have the ice in here ready.
So we're gonna pour this in here, and we're gonna lock it down.
Oh,
now,
no.
Have you ever shaken before?
I have.
Okay, great.
It's like a little...
It's like a football thing. No, that's like really wimpy. You're gonna, you're trying to smash the ice to the front of here, like you're throwing a football inside. Boom! Boom, 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 like that.
Oh my God. Okay. I can't do this to that.
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Yes, you can.
Yeah. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. Like you're making beats, amazing.
Yes, but you have to look very disinterested because you're at a fancy cocktail bar.
Yeah, totally. No, what, Cocktail Academy, you were very interested.
No, you guys are wonderful.
Smiley, okay, give it to me. Done, enough, okay, hired. She's
that
hired.
That was so loud.
Snap it open, okay. Now, before we pour it, we gotta make this glass really creepy. Like before—
I mean, it already is with this lizard tail.
Well, that's no, that's like super like weird. And that's on purpose because that movie is so weird. So what we're gonna do here is we're going to just like when Joaquin Phoenix, when the Joker—
Don't spoil any more movies.
No, yeah, he's, I'm not spoiling, this okay. is not that important.
He is the Joker.
When he's putting on his like Joker makeup. Okay. So we gotta put
that.
Joker makeup on the glass.
Oh.
Hold on, let me get a little bit of ice.
And so here like you have a—
So you're rubbing the outside so, of the glass.
So yeah, we have powdered
a
sugar.
A boat of Alta Subarco. So wow, wait, show the camera, go show
Hold
this
on, wait.
It's so creepy.
It
okay.
should be kind of like wow. getting a little creepy.
So you're rolling the glass in powdered sugar, the outside. Mm-hmm. Ah!
Okay, so that's kind of like the face paint.
Okay,
I get
great.
It. The joke's on
Beautiful.
You.
The joke is on you.
I get it.
And then we're going to pour the drink in here.
So you
oh,
pour
this is beautiful.
Before the glass, before the ice. Oh my gosh,
Correct.
That looks so
well,
creepy.
In this case.
Here, let me move
Now,
over.
I don't know, Baby's can I have a little bit of that Pellegrino? Because when you remove the alcohol, Tammy, thank you so much. Tammy's an absolute gem.
Thank you, Tammy!
Tammy
wins Assistant of the Year award. All right, since we took out the alcohol, it's a little short.
That would have been a lot of booze. Ooh, and it even looks like bloody coming out of there.
It does. Mm-hmm. So this drink is super vegetal. It's definitely a dystopian cocktail. But absolutely
wow.
delicious.
Ah!
That is very cool. You are so creative.
Oh my God, you are amazing.
Don't you?
Can you come home with me and
sure.
tell me that every day?
Yeah.
My wife is super tough on me. She's just like,
she would not be impressed.
Man, you need that, you know? You need someone to push you. I'm not good for you. All right.
Wow.
This is remarkable. And what kind of, remember, just remind us what kind of alcohol you would put in this.
Oh my gosh, the fizz, it looks like blood!
Oh my God, it's so creepy and amazing. The alcohol I'd put in this is gin.
Got it.
Okay. Why? Because I want all those botanicals. Now, what's really interesting, we use marjoram. The herb, and that's muddled in the beet juice. So it gives
okay.
it like this
in
deeper
this
vegetal flavor.
Okay.
Yeah, so taste this. Even without the alcohol, you'll love it. Even with
Can
the extra soda water.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know what else I can say about this except for you
this
have to.
This is why the joke's on us.
There it is.
The joke is on you. Look at this. Enjoy this.
I can't wait to go into our boss's office with white powder all over our faces.
Oh my gosh. And very LA, you feel healthy.
Yes. Oh, I thought like the white powder
oh
very
God,
LA.
No. Delicious.
Okay.
Maybe that too. I don't know.
What I Ooh, will say good. Is all of these cocktails are going to be on our Instagram feed.
Great.
And you
at
can see when at Cocktail Academy
at
underscore ACDMY.
Okay.
And you'll get to see when we're actually in the studio photo producing this, like what we were able to accomplish, and the cocktail photos are amazing.
I mean, this looks so great on our little Five Live studio set. And I'm sure the coasters you bought for LeBron's wife's birthday don't hurt. This looks fantastic.
No, those are very cute. It's amaryth, like very goopy birthday,
goopy.
Kind of like, you know, spiritual crystals,
yeah.
etc.
Yeah. It looks
Listen,
amazing.
The truth is that she deserves that, and everybody deserves an elevated cocktail experience,
yes.
you know?
That's why we have you from the Cocktail Academy.
Matt Landis, everybody.
Hey,
thanks so much for coming.
What a fun segment. I love this so All much.
All right. Be well. We'll see you more
Thank
at Five
you.
Live right
Drink
this.
Well.
There you
Be
have.
Safe.
Thanks, Matt.